In some sense, documentation is at the heart of the human rights movement. The question is, how do you document evidence? Where do you get the evidence from? You know, the human rights movement, when it first got its start, was working in a very different context. You'd often have to sneak paper documents out. So, for example, an organization in the North might send their representative to meet up with a human rights activist, get that information, and then transport it up to a kind of safer environment in the United States or the United Kingdom or Scandinavia or whatever. That's changed totally, because now we have a context in which victims, victims' families, witnesses, bystanders, a whole series of people can be directly involved in documentation because of internet technology, because of cell phones, because of the ability to transmit information quickly outside of the country. Now we have very strong South-based organizations, and they have access to those kinds of communication technologies in a way that, you know, in the past, maybe they needed to be able to, you know, have meetings with ABC News and have meetings with the New York Times editorial board. Now we have a real balance in which you have organizations all over the world that are incredibly strong and robust. Organizations now have at their disposal kind of a whole set of tools to report on human rights abuse that they didn't have before.